Good evening. I am Greg Hillis, and I am the Executive Director of the Aquinas Center. And I want to welcome you all to Canon Chapel for I Will Lift Up My Eyes, a Lenten evening of sacred song with Dr. Tony Alonso and friends. This special concert gives us at the Aquinas Center the opportunity to celebrate the ongoing partnership between the Aquinas Center and Catholic Studies at Candler School of Theology. It's a partnership made possible under the leadership of Dean Jan Love, to whom we owe our tremendous thanks. It also gives us the chance to affirm the vibrant worship life here at Candler under the direction of Dean Kalia Williams, as well as to acknowledge the profound contributions of the Candler singers under the direction of Dr. David Daniel. Thank you to both Dean Williams and to Dr. Daniel. I want to introduce you to some of our performers this evening, and I know you'll get to know our other musicians and performers as the evening progresses. First, allow me to introduce you to Dr. David Daniel, director of the Candler Singers. David was appointed as director of chapel music and assistant professor in the practice of music ministry in 2016. Prior to this appointment, he served Candler as an adjunct instructor and as choral assistant for the Candler Singers since 2011. As director of chapel music, he oversees the musical life of Candler related to weekly worship, such as directing choirs, coordinating staff and student musicians, and guiding student worship planning teams in their choice of congregational song. He also prepares and directs the Candler Singers in leading worship outside of Candler, as well as at Candler, like tonight. We're also honored to have Dr. Chris de Silva with us this evening. Chris is a widely published composer of sacred music, whose music appears in hymnals and in compilations throughout the world. A native of Singapore, Los Angeles is now his home, where he serves as music minister on the Loyola Marymount University campus ministry team. He holds a Bachelor of Music in Music Composition and Film Scoring from the University of Southern California, Thornton School of Music, a Master of Arts in Pastoral Theology from Loyola Marymount University, and most importantly, a Doctor of Ministry from Candler School of Theology at Emory University. Finally, allow me to introduce you to our own Dr. Tony Alonso. I'll talk a bit about his scholarly achievements first. Tony is Aquinas Assistant Professor of Theology and Culture and here at Candler and Director of Catholic Studies. He works at the intersection of theology and culture with a particular focus on worship and ritual practices. His first book, Commodified Communion, Eucharist, Consumer Culture, and the Practice of Everyday Life, offers a theological account of contemporary consumerism and its relationship to the Eucharist. And it's a very good book. It won the 2021 Hispanic Theological Initiative Book Prize, an award that recognizes the best book written by a junior Latinx scholar on theology or religion each year. In 2019, he was awarded the Catholic Theological Society of America's Catherine Lacuna Award for New Scholars for the best academic essay in the field of theology within the Roman Catholic tradition. His second book, The Intimate Notion of Things, Material Transformations in U.S. Catholicism Since Vatican II, is under contract with Fordham University Press. Somehow, in the midst of all this, Tony also composes beautiful liturgical music. He is a Latin Grammy-nominated composer of sacred music and the author of over 200 published compositions and arrangements, including a commission to compose the responsorial psalm for the first Mass Pope Francis celebrated in the United States in 2015. I have to admit that I'm more than a little in awe of Tony. 2 weeks ago, we had the Apostolic Nuncio, Cardinal Christophe Pierre, here on campus, and he celebrated Mass with us. Tony noticed that there wasn't a responsorial for the psalm for that day, so he did what Tony does. He composed one, and it was beautiful. I cannot begin to tell you how excited I am that this concert is happening. and that I am here to experience it, and that you are here too. What a perfect way to enter more deeply into this time of Lent. Let's welcome Tony Alonso and friends.
Joy. heavens and the earth, God looked upon creation with a lover's gaze. God stood in joy and friendship in the garden of the world and sang a hymn of love through all that God had made. Through all that God had made. And God saw that it was good. And God saw. She was chosen to bear the only son by her yes to the Father and her yes to the Son, her yes to the Spirit. The will of God was done. The will of God was done. And God saw that she was good. And God saw.
Blood and tears to show the love of God, to soften every fear. He gazed into our eyes, healing wounds and flushing grace. God's mercy face to face, with him God was well.
And our lives when we risk the gaze of Jesus in a stranger's eyes. Encountering his presence in every face we see, God gazes back at us and sees that we are.
Wow, what a gift it is to share music with so many incredible musicians and to see all of you. The last time we did a concert here was March 4th, 2020. So exactly 4 years ago. And then we shut the world down with it. And many of these same people were here as well. It was a very different kind of concert. I just released a recording of Cuban music called Caminemos con Jesus, and we were celebrating that. I know some of you are here, so it's good to see you back. But it's a blessing to be able to share this evening of Lenten, reflection, and music with you. Thank you so much to the Aquinas Center for hosting us. This next piece is one of the very first songs I ever wrote when I was 19 years old. In fact, I think my friend Dominic was there when I wrote this song. And most of the songs I wrote when I was 19 years old, I don't like to sing anymore. But once in a while, I'll let one sneak in. And this is based on the scripture passage of Matthew 25, 24 to 41. A special song to me in this Lenten season of fasting, prayer, and almsgiving, when we're reminded what the purpose of all that is, preparing ourselves for Easter, creating space in our lives, and especially being attentive to the least among us. We do want you to sing tonight, even though we have so many musicians up here. It'll be like surround sound for me personally if you also sing. So I'd love to teach you this refrain. It sounds like this.
What you have done for the least of my children.
I'd probably write it down a key if I was writing it today, but you can do it. Try that line.
What you have done for the least of my children, you have done for me. You have done for me. What you have given with nothing left to give. You have given me. The stranger outside your door. So when you feed the hungry, when you clothe the poor, I will no longer be just a stranger at your door. Speakers of the has ended. Those who give will receive, those who seek will find. So seek my face in every face. face and see the eyes of God.
I want to introduce folks in stages tonight, because there's so many wonderful folks helping us out. But we have an incredible ensemble of instrumentalists with us. I want to introduce them all to you. Andy Elau on bass, Brian Archer, music director at St. Jude on guitar, Dominic Trumpio from Old St. Pat's in Chicago on flute and other assorted instruments, Mandy Dunaway on oboe, Jonathan Urizar on violin, Maria Patopova?
Close.
Yeah, close enough, sorry. I knew there was something I forgot to practice. On second violin, Patrick Schelk on viola, and Barney Culver on cello. We are so grateful for all of you. And so many of these folks I was blessed to be connected with in different ways, but especially through, I'm a parishioner at Immaculate Heart of Mary on Briarcliff, Jeff Bush over there, retired emeritus music director. Is the reason many of us are connected. Please join in the refrain of this next song the second time it comes around.
In the arms of God, leave your worry and fear. Make your home in the heart of God. God will dry every tear, for the burden you carry will fade within God's care. Come and rest in the arms of God. Gentle is God's way, and humble is God's heart. God's love will light the way that leads to peace. Surely you shall see God's goodness and God's grace. Rest now in God's embrace. Come and rest
in the arms of God.
Come and rest.
Leave your worry and
leave behind your fear.
Make your home in the heart of God.
God will dry every tear. For the burden you carry will fade.
Not be afraid, God heals the broken heart. Through grief and disbelief, God still remains. God and God alone will be your soul's true rest. Fall in the arms of
God will dry every tear.
just like Sunday morning mass. Yeah. Also super grateful to have some incredible singers with me on the far end there. Joe Legospi, who says he's at a parish and a half right now, but really you're like full time at two parishes, St. Peter and Paul in Decatur, and also St. Thomas More in Decatur. So Joe Legospi, happy you're with us. From New York City, music director at St. Francis of Assisi in Midtown Manhattan, a block away from Penn Station, my dear friend Meredith Augustine. And my church music boss, my publisher, vice president of sacred music at GIA Publications, she decides what gets published, she'll be nice to her, Kate Williams. And I should say that the reason why I was able to get so many friends here today is it's my birthday next week. I'm not saying that for you to say happy birthday. I'm saying it because I said for my birthday, I want you to come and we'll have a party and then we'll do a concert. That's what I want for my birthday. So I'm so grateful for people traveling from far and near to be here tonight. This next piece is from a musical work that my friend Jeannie Cotter and I did several years ago based on the writings of Pope Francis. And one of the pieces was, of course, had to do the prayer of St. Francis, make me an instrument of your peace. And I always think of you, Meredith, because we were together in Midtown Manhattan the day of Pope Francis's election. In fact, I was on the other side of town and she texted me and said, hey, there's white smoke, you gotta come over here. And so I scurried down to St. Francis of Assisi, a Franciscan parish, and Meredith, myself, and probably 20 friars sat and watched CNN, and they jokingly said, oh, maybe it'll be someone who'll call himself Francis, and everyone chuckled. and lo and behold, so I'll always have that memory of our time at St. Francis, and if you're ever in New York City, definitely go check out St. Francis of Assisi in Midtown.
Make me an instrument of your peace. Make me an instrument of your peace. Make me an instrument of your peace. Let me so love. Where there is injury, your pardon. Where there is doubt, let me so faith.
Instrument of your peace.
so much to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand.
This next piece is one I wrote for my sister, Lori. When she went off to college, she had a really rough time. Maybe some of you can relate. Going off to a new place, not having a community, it can be a tough time for a lot of people. And when she was really in the depths of despair, I came across this beautiful poem by the hymn writer from New Zealand, Shirley Arena Murray, that she wrote for a friend who was seriously ill. And I really loved it because it was both a song of comfort and in a time when she needed to hear a word of comfort. But also it wasn't kind of like the Hallmark greeting card version of comfort. It left space for the disbelief, for the uncertainty. And so I was very drawn to the text and I sent it to Lori as a gift. And this night, I want to remember all those who are struggling this night in different ways. Jackie praying for your mother, Greg praying for you, and also remembering our sister Celeste Eubanks, who I know, Chris, you know, and she was supposed to be here tonight and she was so excited, and she's in San Diego. So anyone who is struggling this night, this is a prayer for you. And Jesus said.
Of unbelief, but
heal your soul and give your doubting heart
decided to do this concert, I knew right away my first call was to my BFF from Los Angeles, Chris de Silva, who is also, as you heard in the introduction, a Candler alum, Doctor of Ministry alum. I'm very proud of that. I hope that goes in my recruitment column for Catholic Studies. But we're so glad that you're part of our extended community and so happy to have Chris with us. His music is just so wonderful, and it's a wonderful opportunity to be able to share some of it with you tonight. This first song is a song called Belong, and it's, to me, it's quintessential De Silva. His Doctor of Ministry project was about creating inclusive belonging spaces in Catholic communities, and I think this song really reflects both the human and the thinking. So I love it very much. And thinking of those of you, especially I see folks from the Shrine here tonight who are mourning the loss of Monsignor Henry Gratz, who is one of the people that created the most, I think, inclusive space in Atlanta for folks. And this is a piece that was actually sung. I watched the live stream at his vigil. So we remember him in a special way tonight as well. This is Belong.
Shelter, my refuge, my protection, God's holy light. And I belong to you, I belong to you, my God. I belong to you, I belong to you, my God.
I gaze on the beauty of my Savior. One thing I ask, one thing of my Lord I seek, to live in the house of my Redeemer, God's safe embrace. And I belong to you, I belong to you, my God. I belong to you, I belong to you, my God.
The goodness, the glory of God's kingdom, this I will see. This place of eternal peace. I wait for my God,
my hope, my freedom, God's saving
The second call was to David Daniel. We have been wanting to, one of the great gifts of being a part of the Candler community is our incredible worship under the direction of Dean Kalia Williams, and also the music ministry under the direction of David Daniel every Tuesday and Thursday and many special occasions. It is such a joy to worship in this space. You're always welcome Tuesdays and Thursdays at 11:05. But one of the great gifts is the incredible gift of the Candler singers, and we have never been able to do anything outside of kind of regular working hours, and David is always up for new things, so we're delighted to have the Candler singers. Thank you for your yes tonight. It's been a joy to work with you, and you're in for a real treat for these next several songs. This next piece, one of the gifts of tonight is Chris. For many years, I would lean on him, especially when I was pursuing a PhD and I didn't have time to arrange all these songs. I would lean on him, but even before that, because his undergraduate degree is actually in film scoring. So he's an incredible arranger. And he took over my position at Loyola Marymount in Los Angeles,
yes,
where I was
did.
The music minister for many years, and a successor in every definition of the word. But before he was in that position, and I was in it, I was commissioned by Loyola Marymount to write a song for the centennial year of the school. And it's very hard to write a song for your own community. I was very, very nervous about it, and usually I finish things way before deadline, but this was not one of those times. So I was kind of up to the last minute.
Mm-hmm.
And this song is called The Greater Glory of God, which is one of the, you know, many beautiful phrases associated with the Society of Jesus. But one of the beautiful things about Loyola Marymount is that it has three founding religious communities, two of whom often get their short shrifts, the Sisters of St. Joseph of Orange and the Religious of the Sacred Heart of Mary. Sometimes they get subsumed under those Jesuits. They have their ways. So I really wanted to honor all three of these founding religious communities in this song. So you hear their mottos, that all may have life, that all may be one for the greater glory of God. And I mention all of this because I was so last minute, I asked Chris to do this arrangement about a week before.
Yes, that's right.
Yeah.
That is correct.
Yeah.
It went kind of like this.
There is drama and trauma, yes. And I said, I want it to be cinematic.
Yeah.
I want it to be beautiful and cinematic. Because, you know, we're in LA after all, you know, come on. So this is a song that I don't think he realized he'd be playing every week for the remaining 12 years of our lives. I'm sorry for that. But
but thank you.
Song I never get to do in concert because we never have this many instruments and I never have Chris here and we never have a great choir. So happy to share it with you. This is The Greater Glory of God.
Blessed and broken through every joy and pain. You weave our many stories as one though many parts. You shape us as one body within your sacred heart.
We can do no great things. We can do no great things. We can do no great things. Only small things with great love. We can do no great things. Use us as instruments, simple vessels of your peace. Inspire in us pure hearts of understanding, to know that in your warm embrace our beings will find rest. Sacred vessels of your will, transform in us new hearts of God's compassion, to live true lives of readiness. We listen for your
project that I worked on with Chris and our friend, Father Liam Lawton from Ireland, well-known composer. It's a work, musical work, around Sarah Bogue, you'll appreciate this, Writings of the Mystics, called The Castle of the Soul. And this particular piece is the title piece, and it's based on the writings of the 16th century Spanish mystic and nun, Teresa of Avila, especially her book, The Interior Castle. And in the book, Teresa speaks of contemplative soul as a castle with many rooms in it. And in the innermost room is where she envisioned union with God. And the refrain of this piece comes from one of her most well-known phrases that you might have heard maybe in a Tese song or something like that. Nada te turbe, nada te espante, todo se pasa, Dios no se muda. Let nothing disturb you, let nothing frighten you. All things pass away, God never changes. So this is called Castle of the Soul.
Castle of the Soul. Nothing will disturb you in God's heart.
11:05, Tuesdays and Thursdays. This next piece, the last three pieces we're gonna do for you tonight all come from the same project around themes of Christian pilgrimage, largely influenced by writings about the Camino. And this particular piece is an interesting mashup of things. The words are from a medieval pilgrim song. The tune is from Ireland. And I don't know, it's, you know, arranged by a Singaporean and a Cuban. So it's kind of global. It's a global piece, okay? But I was really excited tonight. We have so many incredible musicians here and out there. And one of them is my dear friend, who is the music director at the Shrine downtown Atlanta, Donal Noonan. And I said, do you mind being typecast for a song? And he is so gracious that he was willing to do it. So we're super excited to have Donal join us for this next song, Stella Splendens.
Listen to the stories, the prophets and the pilgrims. trouble. Strength when we are weary, and comfort in our struggle.
I'd like to say something. Tony, give me a little space here. I just wanted to say. No, I just want to thank Tony for this invite to be here as part of this. And just a little thing to say that Candler is really sacred space, especially Candler Chapel, having done all my studies here. And so I'm very grateful for this opportunity. So thank you everyone for being here.
Poverty,
us reach out willingly.
So many people to thank. Huge, huge thanks. Well, I'll say it the nice way. We've just had an incredible experience today with the sound in Canon Chapel, and that is kind of hit or miss. So I'm super, super, super grateful to Keon Dorsey. I don't know where you are, Keon, but it's just, oh, there you are. I'm in the Keon fan club. He's just an absolute delight to work with. He made us feel really great today and did such a wonderful job. So we're so grateful for the gift that you bring to this. Also, so grateful to so many Candler staff members, to Stan Taylor, who is incredible helping out today, to Sarah Macklin, who is incredible arranging so many things throughout the day, as well as her staff. And of course, we couldn't do this without the great gift that is the Aquinas Center here at Candler and Emory. So special thanks to Greg for inviting us to do this. And Alice Cameron, wherever you are, for making all of this happen and even inviting us to break our Lenten fast with sweets after this concert. And whenever Alice is in charge of food, it's always good. So it's not just going to be like a Publix cookie, although those are good too, like those too. But it's going to be good dessert. So I hope you join us for the reception afterwards. It'll be really wonderful. But we're so, so deeply grateful to all the folks. Thank you so much to the Candler singers and to David Daniel for all the hours. A true, true blessing. And thank you to all my incredible musician friends, old and new, for being a part of this tonight. So very grateful. This last piece is the title of the concert tonight, I Will Lift My Eyes, and it's a song I wrote actually when I first started doctoral study at Emory. And we were working on this collection of music around themes of Christian pilgrimage, and I remember listening to this interview with this person on NPR, this therapist, and she was talking about how any one of these things could cause your life to enter into a state of extreme disequilibrium. And she started listing them off. One was the move to a new city, one was the end of a relationship, one was the loss of a loved one or a new diagnosis. And I kind of laughed because I was like, check, 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 check. And around that same time, our friend Liam sent us all of this poetry and things to get us inspired for this project. And on the top of the first page was this poem from a Celtic mystic. And it began, "It is time for me to pass from the shelter of a habitation to journey as a pilgrim over the waves of the bold and splendid sea." And in light of everything that was happening at the time, I was really drawn to that little poem, and I would kind of pray it to myself as I walked up and down North Decatur Road to and from school. And gradually it became a song. Thomas Merton entered the chat and other things started to happen. The Psalms entered as well. And we share it to end tonight, I think, for many reasons, but especially because Lent itself is a kind of pilgrimage to those waters, those death-dealing and life-giving waters of baptism. And like all of life, it is a journey that is often uncertain and messy and imperfect, filled with wrong turns and frustrating detours. Amen, Atlanta traffic. Yet, through it all, we hold firm to this promise of the one who promises to walk with us, not because everything is perfect, certainly not because we have everything figured out, not because our faith is always as strong as we might hope it to be, but exactly because we are imperfect people in a wounded world, trying to make sense of our joys and our pains, trying to make sense of each other. And Lent is most of all a journey of preparation, not only for Easter, but more deeply for that heavenly home beyond this one. And so, trusting in that hope that surpasses all understanding, let us end our time together this night, lifting our eyes to the mountain, from where shall come our help.
It is time for me to move from my shelter of safety, to sail as a pilgrim over the waves of the sea. It is time to be still and to seek the Son of Mary. Time to rest, time to leave behind my fears. And I will not fear the storm, though it rages around me. For slowly I am learning to place my trust in you, to forgive every hurt and to loosen every burden, to let go and to follow where you lead. And I will lift my eyes to the mountains, from where shall come my help. My help shall come from the Lord. So I'll walk in the light of the path set before me, for I know your love will show me the way. Though I know you have prepared a path for me to follow, I'll never know for certain that I follow where you lead. Still I trust that my desire to please you will guide me, and I trust that you will keep me from harm.
We even got three deans in here tonight. At least three, maybe more. Jan, thank you so much, especially for being here. So, so grateful for all your support.
Were I the perfect child of God, whose faith was deep and love was broad, not doubtful, guilty, worn or flawed, I'd gladly follow Jesus. But I'm the child of what I've been, estranged by much I've done and seen, afraid to show the love I mean, unfit to follow Jesus.
That God who knows me first and last, who's seen my best, my worst, my past, has shown his love intense and vast by meeting me in Jesus.
For Christ, though killed at Calvary, my sins like mine and folk like me, has risen, forgiven, and set me free, made fit to follow Jesus. Sprinkle water on my brow, as in this place I make my vow, to own and love my Savior now, and give myself to Jesus. God grant me what I still require, that I in others might inspire the hidden hope, the deep desire to love and follow Jesus. God grant me what I still require, that I in others might inspire the hidden hope, the deep desire to love and follow Jesus. To love and follow Jesus.
Thank you.